seem to do fine for folks who are celebrating Mother's Day out there.
I think so. Hopefully everyone got in some good activities, whatever you were doing today. We kind of had a pretty start with the blue skies and then saw those clouds increase. And moving into tonight, we actually have rain moving in. So it's just like, boom, right into tonight and tomorrow, we've got the rain back in the forecast.
So that's probably going to mess up the aurora if anybody wanted to try and spot that tonight.
I would think so, yeah. I mean, good luck to you if you want to get out there and take a look. But we do have the clouds that have definitely moved in. And in fact, we're expecting some stormy kind of weather to start the week. A couple of rounds, in fact, of heavy rain are going to be on the way only in the next couple of days, and then maybe a few more rounds later in the week. We will see, but it does look like within the next maybe 2 or 3 days, we're going to have one round possibly tonight to early tomorrow morning, and that would be mostly north of the lake, it looks like. And then tomorrow night, I would definitely big heads up for some heavy storms moving in, maybe late evening to about 9 or 10 p.m. and then into the overnight, probably finishing up around sunrise Tuesday. We're talking about 1 to maybe 4 inches of rain. Higher totals are possible north. This is a setup where we have a little bit higher chance for this heavy rain north as opposed to south of the lake. And yes, when you get that much rain moving in with these systems, if it comes pretty quick, which it might, street flooding may be possible. And we also have a severe risk. So a lot to talk about in the forecast. I'll get you ready for it. But those are the two main time frames for the rain, it looks like. First of all, we also have that flood watch, and it starts 7 p.m. tonight north, but 7 a.m. tomorrow south of Lake Pontchartrain. And clearly the rain is ongoing right now north of the lake. Our radar is picking up on some lighter showers, so nothing too active yet. But we have been watching a few of these storms actually weakening as they've moved off to the east from Lafayette toward Baton Rouge. So hopefully no strong weather in the next couple of hours, but we'll be watching. And it does look like there will be at least showers north of the lake. A tornado watch is in the red box out to our west, but that has not been extended into our area. And some of these stronger storms are taking a little bit more of this kind of pull to the north as they move across our state from the west to the east. So we will see there's a warm front moving in. That was that nice cool front before it moves south of our coast. And now we're seeing warmer air start to move back in tonight. And this would be more overnight. I think two out of five level risk of severe storms are going to be with us. And then tomorrow we're all at, including the South Shore, a level 2 out of 5. This is meaning some high wind gusts, maybe some hail. A tornado, unfortunately, can't be ruled out, but that does look like a lower threat than the others. And then the flooding might be a concern. Again, if we get a quick couple of inches of rain, or maybe even a bit more than that, especially north, that could cause some street flooding issues. So we do have those severe weather threats. This is going to be mostly tomorrow night. But check out, actually tonight even, we have a flooding rain outlook mostly out to our west, but we are included at that lowest level for maybe some flooding rains tonight. But look at tomorrow. We've been increased to the level 3 out of 4. Now this is kind of confusing because it's not the severe look, which I just showed you, but rather just the heavy rain threat. And it does look like we may have some of these heavier downpours causing a few problems, possibly tomorrow. Again, mostly tomorrow night. So how much rain in the next 3 days? The oranges and reds, that's about 3 to 4 inches of rain. And notice that does move all the way toward Lake Pontchartrain. The blues are more like 1 or so inches of rain. So that's why there's a bit of a range, but the heavier rain totals do look to stay north. Now, our model did an okay job of picking up on what's happening now. Then moving toward 9 and 10 p.m., it kind of lifts any of those storms and much of that rain to the north of us. Look at this, though. It has another round tonight, 6 a.m. tomorrow. So this would be before sunrise, starting to get some heavier downpours, maybe quickly passing some of our North Shore spots. But by 7 and 8, this model does have it moving out. So chance of rain early tomorrow, I would say a bigger heads up north of the lake if you're leaving from somewhere on the North Shore for that early commute. Looking at tomorrow, notice this model doesn't have that much rain during the day, but 7 p.m. and then this is 10 p.m. tomorrow, and we'll fast forward to midnight. Here is that next round of some heavy storms before we get this cool down moving in on Tuesday. And actually, it's not much of a cool down. It's a cool front officially, but it's going to be still a pretty warm day, but a little lower humidity, I think, during the rest of the day. Tuesday, Wednesday, it's hot and dry. And then later in the week, we'll have an almost kind of standard summer-like forecast with at least a chance for scattered storms each day. LSU